What's the ceiling?
Douche rocket. Diarrhea.
World peace. People ask me such fucked up questions. You have absolutely smelled a fart in a Barnes & Noble.
Hey, I'm Taylor Tomlinson, and it's time for Ask a Comedian. So these are actual, real questions that you guys thought I might be able to answer. What weird rituals do you need to do before you go on stage? People always ask this. I don't know what people want me to say. Like, I have sex. I don't know what people want. I really just like drink hot water with lemon and panic, doubt my abilities as a performer, comedian, and human being. What is the worst pre-show meal? Anything that even flirts with diarrhea. I tend to like spicy food. I have learned that that is a post-show meal, and I have learned that the hard way. What was the first role you ever auditioned for? My father's approval. No, I'm kidding. Like, I think I'm just too insecure to be an actor. I shouldn't be saying this. I should be telling Netflix I'm good at acting. I'm great. I love acting. What's a movie you pretend you've seen, but you really never have? I haven't seen Neverending Story. Should I have seen that? What a lame thing to pretend. To like go on Tinder dates and they're like, have you seen Neverending Story? And you're like, I mean, who hasn't? Like, what song do you like to walk out on stage to? Boys Wanna Be Her by Peaches. What's the weirdest gift you've ever received? There was a guy, I believe in DC on tour, who was in the meet and greet, who had made business cards that said Detective Douche Rocket with, I assume, his phone number. Shouldn't have done that. But it was a reference to a quarter life crisis, and I thought that was pretty fun.
And I said, all right, Detective Douche Rocket.
But pretty weird thing to order on a bunch of business cards. So whoever had to fill that order, I hope they watched the special.
You are a Scorpio. Do you identify with your zodiac sign and why? Unfortunately, yes.
Scorpios are like jealous, passionate, and loyal, and I identify as all of those things. But I do feel like nobody's ever stoked to be a Scorpio. Like whenever someone's like, oh, you're a Scorpio. Like there's always that. It's never like, oh, you're a Scorpio. It's just like, okay. What comedians did you look up to growing up? Brian Regan, I looked up to a lot because I grew up really religious and he was like one of the only comedians you could listen to with your conservative father in the car. And then I got to open for him in my early 20s a few times and he's like the nicest, funniest person ever. I think that's like so cool when you get to meet a hero of yours and they're just as nice and gracious as they are funny and smart. What other celebrity do you get mistaken for? I've never been mistaken for a celebrity ever. I am told I look like a couple different people. I've been getting Florence Pugh lately. I don't see it at all. I wish I looked like Florence Pugh. When you have a pimple, do you pick it or leave it alone? As I have grown older and more mature, I have learned to leave it alone. Does that help? No. How does bombing on stage feel compared to a breakup? Bombing is the worst, but it's nowhere near as painful as a breakup. Because a breakup, someone who knows you well doesn't like you. I would rather bomb every night for a month than go through even a nice breakup, which doesn't exist. When people are like, no, it's a nice breakup. Like they both fell out of love at the same time. That's not a thing that happens. Falling out of love at the same time is like coming at the same time. It only happens in movies and we have to stop pretending otherwise. I have feelings for my married coworker. Should I tell them? I am also married. People ask me such fucked up questions. No? It sounds like you want to do it. If you're asking a comedian, should I ruin my marriage and someone else's? Sounds like you made up your mind. Well, I hope I answered some of your questions. Now it's my turn to ask you to go watch my new special, Look at You, on Netflix right now.